The Celebration Bowl represents the rich legacy of black college football. For 130 years, with its pageantry and all of the outstanding talent it produced, the spectacle became a critical pillar of the unique HBCU experience. But black college football is more than its past. It's very relevant in the here and now.
New kings of the conference.
Coach Prime, Deion Sanders, brings style and substance.
It's not just about winning. We're going to win. It's about making things better for everybody.
All eyes of the HBCU football world are on Deion Sanders.
Challenging the assumption that the greatness of HBCU football is in the past.
This is not just time for Jackson State. This is time for HBCUs to shine.
And let's not sleep on South Carolina State and its head coach, Buddy Pough, who brings 30 years of experience into this championship game.
It's been a long time coming. I've been trying to get to this thing for about 10 years.
A new surge of greatness is on the horizon. With one of the nation's top recruits on his way to Jackson State, you better believe the college football landscape has changed forever. From those humble beginnings of 1892 until now, the Celebration Bowl sums up the essence of the black college experience.
If you want me, you can find me in the A. We're inside Mercedes-Benz Stadium, the site of the 2021 Cricket Celebration Bowl. A black college national champion will be crowned here between South Carolina State and Jackson State as we welcome you in to Black College Live.
Yeah.
You're watching Gimme 5.
Black College Live.
The Black College Live.
Yeah. This is a Gimme 5 show with Jay Walker and Tiffany. Hey. Yeah. You gon' have to give me 5 fingers on it. Right now.
I'm all excited. You see that?
Waiting till they see the strength and hear the wind. It's Black College Live. I'ma need 5 on it.
This is what it's all about.
Overtime on it. Lights out.
I'ma put him in the front runner seat to be the Black College Player of the Year.
Same for fun. I've been going done. They be still trying to clone it. From fam, you to grambling, I'm on it. Stand on it. March 100, how you want it.
We always like to highlight the fraternities and sororities.
119!
Oh, yeah. Sky Cam action coming your way inside the Mercedes-Benz Stadium. We say what's
mama,
up, what's
I made
up?
It. I made it. I'm on Sky Cam, mama. I made it here in Atlanta.
What it
get
do.
Get ready for it.
Jay Walker, Tiffany Greene, delighted to have you with us. How about the marching 101 from South Carolina State?
Their
drum line is here as well. As Bulldog fans are ready to get going, they'll take on the Tigers of Jackson State in the Cricket Celebration Bowl. Jay, this has all the feels. We've done this since 2015 when this was instituted. It just gets better and better.
And absolutely. And I think what has been clearly one of the most memorable seasons of HBCU football, period, during the spring football season. Carry that to the fall. And in the fall, the more traditional case. And we always know in the black college football landscaping, you start the season in the A, and if you have a great season, you end up here in Atlanta again for the Cricket Celebration Bowl for a national championship.
You talked about some of the things within the historically black colleges and universities landscape. Well, let's look at what's happened in the football world over the last few weeks. How about Hugh Jackson leaving his post as the offensive coordinator at Tennessee State to take over a legendary program in Grambling State?
Well, one of the things that Coach Deion Sanders has brought to HBCU landscape, everybody's looking for the splash hire. And I believe Hugh Jackson going to Grambling State is clearly a splash hire. With his NFL pedigree and the experience that he brings to the table, how could you not want to go play quarterback at Grambling for Hugh Jackson? Great move by the Tigers. We'll see if he can score some points.
Well, let's stay in the boot because his rival in Southern University just picked up one of their native sons as Eric Dooley returns to Louisiana to head the Southern Jaguars program.
Yeah, Eric Dooley was one of the best offensive coordinators in the conference and then a fantastic head coach at Prairie View A&M. Young rising star. Southern went after him. They wanted to get their man. They got him. He played football at Grambling, but coached under legendary coach Pete Richardson, as well as Robert Cloud and Grambling. He's back in Louisiana. great move by the Jaguars.
Let's stick with that rising star theme, because Shedeur Sanders is continuing to grow in his legend. Just in his first season at Jackson State University, winning the Jerry Rice Award, the first HBCU player to do so.
We knew he was a phenomenal football player, but the rest of America realized that as well. The young man just simply makes great decisions with the football. 11-1 as a freshman starter there. One of the best you're going to see in the FCS level. He's an NFL talent. Congratulations to baby prime Shedeur Sanders.
He makes great decisions, doesn't throw a lot of interceptions, but the other man lining up against him, and Decobie Durant, the MEAC Defensive Player of the Year for South Carolina State, hopes he can grab a pick or two.
You know, when you think about South Carolina State, you think of they always got guys making it to the National Football League on the defensive side of the ball, from Robert Porche, Chardrick Darby, Javon Hargrave, Darius Leonard. Decobie Durant is that next dude for South Carolina State. He'll be playing in the NFL. Congratulations to MEAC Defensive Player of the Year.
It will be interesting, Jay, because something has to give between those two. Let's take a look at the other notable postseason accolades. How about Jawan Carter, the great year he had at Norfolk State University. He was the MEAC Offensive Player of the Year. And we go over to the SWAC, Aquil Glass on the offensive side, and Isaiah Land, the Defensive Player of the Year out of Florida A&M.
That really lets me know the talent level was tremendous. We talked about how great Shedeur Sanders was. Second team all conference. He's got motivation because Aquil Glass was just that dude. He's an NFL caliber quarterback. They all get it. Isaiah Land still up for the Buchanan Award. So we saw a phenomenal year of HBCU talent on the football field, and they were well rewarded.
As we cap off this great year, Jay, let's take a look at our Cricket Celebration Bowl power rankings, and how does everything shake out at the end of the season?
Well, I'm going to go outside the box a little bit. We got Prairie View A&M on the bubble. Eric Dooley, they came a game short from making it to the Cricket Celebration Bowl. Number five, though, let's give credit to Bowie State University. The Bulldogs did a great job. Damon Wilson, young coach on the rise. Somebody's going to hire him and pick him up. Number four, South Carolina State, the Bulldogs. Why are they number four? Because Coach Buddy Pough went out there and played the toughest schedule in all of HBCU football. They backed down from nobody, and they made it to Atlanta anyway. Number three, Alabama A&M. They were number one to start the season. They hit a bump in the road, but towards the end of the year, they were able to right the ship. Head coach Connell Maynard, offensive guy, got it going. Aquil Glass, their quarterback we talked about. The Bulldogs finished up strong. Number two, what do they do, Tiffany? The Rattlers.
Strike, strike, and strike again.
And they were striking a lot of people this year with a championship caliber defense. They were really just 1 point away from possibly winning the SWAC Eastern Division there, but Willie Simmons did a good job. A lot of talent there. The Rattlers, good job. And number one, surprise, surprise, the story of the spring, the story of the offseason, the fighting primes of Jackson State University.
All right. The I love is what they like to say in the city of Seoul, as the Tigers are the top-ranked team in HBCU football. Well, that's what's happening on the field inside the Mercedes-Benz Stadium. The marching 101 from South Carolina State, warming up for their halftime performance.
This one's for every sports fan who just spent the entire game explaining to someone the entire game. You've compromised enough. Pepsi Zero Sugar.
This is where the formula ends and the magic begins. We take the mold, shake the mold, and break the mold. From late nights in the gym to later nights in the library, we grind. Because if you think greatness is a game, think again. Here, nothing shines unless we all do.
A beautiful venue for a champion to be crowned in and rising inside the Mercedes-Benz Stadium. A champion will rise for this Cricket Celebration Bowl.
Can I tell you something? With that sky cam view right there, hey, halftime, if you've never seen an HBCU halftime, that's a problem. But when you watch a halftime with that sky cam, I'm going to watch the monitor. I'm not even going to watch on the field. It's going to look phenomenal.
The great part about it is you can see the entire performance uninterrupted on the ESPN app. So you'll definitely want to check that out. Well, you know, Jay, the fact that we get a chance week in and week out to go to campuses and take a look at not only what it's like to be a student there, but also participate in the organizations. I'm a proud member of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated.
What's your little squeak y'all do?
I'm not going to do it here, but I'm just throw up a sign real quick. Okay, we don't do it on demand, all right? But what I will say is we've had a chance to intertwine with the Divine Nine as they have graced our Black College Live show. Let's take a look back at some of the Greeks of the week. Jay, that we got a chance to capture that experience. Yes. That's a part of the HBCU experience. Now, Jay, I know you were part of the football team and a number of guys, you know, Cross Q and Sigma. What happened to you?
I was too good a football player.
Mm-hmm.
Too good a football player to join. I wanted to win a championship on the field. And I had some battles, too. I went off the field as well. I went to Howard. Look it
what
up.
They said you,
look
you,
it up. I went to Howard. I'm just going to leave
time
it
out,
there.
Time out. They said you weren't pretty enough to be a Kappa. You weren't dirty enough to be a Q. You weren't smart enough to be an Alpha. You want me to keep going?
But I was good enough to make it to the NFL. Let's get back to Black College Live. All right.
Booyah, booyah. All right, so, Jay, as we switch to the NFL, you know, what's so unique about both of these programs is the fact that they have four Pro Football Hall of Famers at each of these schools.
Four apiece.
Is quite impressive. You see the list here, Marion Motley, Deacon Jones, Harry Carson, and Donnie Shell for South Carolina State. Sweetness, Walter Payton, along with Jackie Slater, who led the way for him. Robert Brazil, along
Dr.
with
Dr. Doom. Was that one of the best nicknames ever?
Yeah.
Dr. Doom, the linebacker, Robert Brazil.
But we have to shout out the latest addition to the Pro Football Hall of Fame, Donnie Shell, and we'd like to thank our friends at NFL Films for this wonderful piece on the Pro Football Hall of Famer.
Donnie Shell went from undrafted rookie to unstoppable force on Pittsburgh's famed Steel Curtain defense.
And it is tipped and then intercepted. Donnie Shell with the ball.
Nicknamed the Torpedo for his uncanny ability to seek out the ball or ball carrier, Shell was a mainstay at strong safety for 14 seasons. He was a three-time first-team All-Pro and a five-time Pro Bowler.
It's his 50th. He's the first strong safety in history to intercept 50 passes.
His 51 career interceptions are the most by any strong safety in NFL history.
And looky, looky here, who do we have, Jay Walker? There are so many people that continue to stop by our Black College Live show throughout this season, and another South Carolina State great.
I really don't like this dude being this close to me, man. You talk about somebody that terrorized MEAC. My friend now, Black College Hall of Fame legend, member of the Detroit Lions, Ring of Honor, and all that good stuff. We were so proud of you. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Robert Porche.
Thank you.
Get away from me, man.
Give it up for Robert Porche. What does it mean for South Carolina State to play on this stage? It means so much. I got to know that.
It's great. I want to commend both teams for getting here. This is truly an honor to play in a game like this. I wish we had the Celebration Bowl years and years ago when I played, you wouldn't have made it.
The Bison, we'd have still got there, but you know, I get to keep going.
This is your show, so I'll let you go with that. But it's a great opportunity. I think it's the experience for the students is phenomenal. It's a great recruiting tool also. So I know Coach Pugh and his staff has been doing a little bit of that. Spent some time with them last night. So hopefully, you know, it'll be a good showing for us.
Here's what people want to know. I talked about the number of players that come to the National Football League from South Carolina State. What y'all got in that water down there in Orangeburg, particularly on the defensive side of the football? Darius Leonard, Chadwick Darby, yourself, Donnie Shell, Harry Carson. What are y'all doing down there defensively? How do y'all keep it going year after year?
We just get after quarterbacks. We like getting after quarterbacks, man, and I think that'll be the difference for us tomorrow. I know nobody's giving us a chance tomorrow, but I think our defensive line is just better than the offensive line, but they're going to have to show it tomorrow. But that's what it is. We like getting after quarterbacks down there. We chase quarterbacks.
You chase them. All right, last question for you. What did going to an HBCU mean to you? What is that experience about? Your son now goes to North Carolina A&T. Right. What's that HBCU experience like for the culture?
It's just a family atmosphere. I started at Tennessee State, so I was there 2 years and then transferred to South Carolina State, but didn't miss a beat when I transferred because of that camaraderie. I can still go on campus now. A couple of my instructors are still there. And, you know, you just know people personally. That's what I like, just the personality of it.
That's the beauty of HBCUs. And he wasn't kidding about chasing those quarterbacks, 95 and a half sacks throughout his career and his 13 years in the NFL. Hey, look, we got plenty more to go. So you want to stick around. Put a little wind in your sails. The Marching 101, warm it up.
This is where the formula ends and the magic begins. We take the mold, shake the mold, and break the mold. From late nights in the gym to later nights in the library, we grind. Because if you think greatness is a game, think again. Here, nothing shines unless we all do.
Up the grill for one hot dog? Seriously?
Hot dogs, better with Pepsi.
There will come a time in your life that you'll have to ask yourself,
are you next?
The next Hall of Famer.
I hear you call it.
The next great leader.
Element in the periodic table. Yes,
the next nuclear engineer.
The next great musician.
Are you next?
Are you next?
I'm next.
South Carolina State University. Are you next?
How you doing? You're watching Black College Live with Jay and Tiff. They're good.
We in the ATL, shouty, yeah! Woo! Mercedes-Benz Stadium overhead shot overlooking this great city. The Peach State has been kind to us, Jay. You talked about we start the season in the A,
in
and
the
we
A.
End it here in the A.
In the
you
A.
You're not throwing up no
signs. I'm not throwing. You're just so young sometimes.
Look, youthfulness, it keeps you going. That's all I'm going to say. You date yourself if you want to. All right, ladies and gentlemen, as we tell you a little bit bit more about these terrific institutions, let's first introduce you to Jackson State University, challenging minds.
JSU.
Okay, there we go, and changing lives. Approximately 6,400 students enrolled in a fantastic institution that originally started as Natchez Seminary, and a number of notable alums have come through. As we mentioned, also those four Pro Football Hall of Famers. But Jay, the game continues to change for Jackson State. They lead the FCS in attendance. We have seen this resurgence of a blue blood of black college football.
I mean, I'm going to tell you right now, we said this a couple years ago about North Carolina A&T. We saw them becoming the hottest HBCU in the country before they became the largest HBCU in the country. Right now, Jackson State is the hottest HBCU in the country. Everybody knows about what they're doing, and the football success has a big reason why.
Well, they were absolutely superb on the field. Perfect, in fact, in the Southwestern Athletic Conference en route to their first SWAC championship since 2007, and they have a vaunted defense, one of the best in the country, and the postseason accolades continued to pour in for the Tigers. And you talked about that prime time effect. You know, this was something interesting that our production crew came up with. That number 21 is ever so important to Deion Sanders. He wore it during his 14-year NFL career. He was hired at Jackson State on the 21st of September in 2020. They moved the game, okay? His first ever game as a collegiate head coach to February 21st, which was a Sunday, by the way, and that win over Edward Waters, and that 21 or less they've held opponents to.
I saw those 21s, and now when you said it out loud, I started thinking, did they do that? Was it the 21st day of September? Like Earth, Wind, and Fire?
Remember?
They remember down there, one of the greatest hires in HBCU in recent memory, and they've been well rewarded. And he knew where he was getting into, but to see Jackson State, one of the blue bloods, having the success they have, hats off to the athletic director, Ashley Robinson. Job well done.
You talk about the rewards. Well, certainly he was able to cash in on them this week with National Signing Day as the number two recruit in our ESPN Top 300 decided to flip his decision from Florida State to Jackson State. Major move, and the Atlanta metro area continuing to love on one of their native sons, if you will.
I mean, once we got off the plane, everybody was already talking about Jackson State, but now everybody is talking about Travis Hunter and the decision he made to go to Jackson State and HBCU. And I'm telling you, they're not done. We talked to the coaching staff. They've got some more people that are knocking. I'm talking to other coaches around the country. They're telling me how close they are to signing some big-time recruits. This is the tidal wave that my best friend, Calvin Wilson, the dentist, has always said, why don't more kids go to HBCUs? Well, they're coming, and we're going to see how long this wave lasts. I don't think we're going anywhere.
Well, you know, what's interesting is the fact that they didn't have that decision before, where you had to go to an HBCU if you wanted to be educated, and they produced some of the best that's ever played in NFL football. But now you've got choices. But to make that decision to go back to an HBCU, coming home, if you will, it's that family atmosphere that draws them in, Jay.
Yeah, and this also to go along with it, I think the name, image, and likeness really helps out a lot. You know, really helps out because you can go there. We always knew you could be the big fish in a small pond, and you may have to sacrifice some of the bling. But now with NIL, you don't have to sacrifice that bling. We see these kids out here now. Shedeur Sanders, one of the best NIL deal athletes out there, and he's going to be joined. So I think they're doing it the right way. And this is a shock and a change, and I'm really telling you, it's not going nowhere.
Let's talk about a person who's done it the right way, and that's Buddy Pough. He is a product of that small school in Orangeburg, South Carolina. Yeah, let's tell you about South Carolina State, founded in 1896, and just under 3,000 students at that fantastic university, the ROTC Bulldog Battalion, most enrolled cadets. They continue to flush out and produce the most black generals in the Army.
How about this? You saw the majority whip, Jim Clyburn. He's going to be the honorary team captain for the Bulldogs tomorrow. They're pulling out all the stops. They want this.
He was so important. He wanted to be here for that. So he sent his representative, which is the president of the United States, to be the commencement speaker at South Carolina State. Let's recap the Bulldogs and how they were able to get here. We talked about going perfect in the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference this season. They won their 18th, that's a record 18th title.
Yeah, I mean, they played too many games, but then outside of that, they took on the who's who of HBCU football, and they were rewarded with it. Not afraid to take on anybody. They dominated the MEAC, winning all their games. And who says you can't teach an old dog new tricks? Buddy Pough, MEAC Coach of the Year in 2021, who saw that coming?
All-time winningest coach at his alma mater, and we see the difference that it made for them to go from non-conference to MEAC play, as you mentioned, Jay. They are coming in hot, winners of 5 in a row. All right, so Jay, you know, we always like to do this at this time. This is your bread and butter. This is your franchise. You dream this up. It is still here. It's rolling. It's time for Jay's Gimme Five.
Gimme Five. All right, we're down here in the A. So how about the five things you need to know about the Celebration Bowl down here in Atlanta? It's Jay's Gimme Five, right? So let's show you number five right there. Number five, you got the Blue Bloods taking place in this game. Jackson State, historic program in the SWAT. You've got South Carolina State, history right there when you talk about the Blue Bloods. Number four, it's the MEAC versus SWAC. I'm a MEAC guy, right? You know that. And the SWAC has changed. They dominate all the headlines. But the MEAC is still saying, we're 4-1 in the Celebration Bowl. The SWAC's going to have to prove that they can beat them down here in Atlanta. Number three, the bands. You talk about the Marching 101, who we're hearing right now. But let's not forget about the Sonic Boom of the South. And I don't know, did I mention that we got Skycam to see the bands at halftime? So you're really going to enjoy seeing that. Number two, I'm old school. National championships mean something. Jackson State wins this game, undisputed national champion. Jackson State falls, FAMU comes into the loop, South Carolina State will jump up high, it'll play out on the field. And the number one reason to come down here, it's in the Hotlanta. What do you call it, Tip? We're in the what?
A!
The A! Hotlanta is jumping right now. Everybody in the HBCU landscape is talking about it. Jackson State primetime, Deion coming back to Atlanta. This is big.
We're going to keep it popping. Yeah, I got a question, Jay. How you feeling about that Skycam? I know you're falling in love with it. We've got more. One more block on the way from Black College Live. We'll see you soon.
You're watching Black College Live with Tiffany Greene and Jay Walker.
This is where the formula ends and the magic begins. We take the mold, shake the mold, and break the mold. From late nights in the gym to later nights in the library, we grind. Because if you think greatness is a game, think again. Here, nothing shines unless we all do.
When was the last time you experienced something different?
Welcome back in to Black College Live. Jay Walker along with Tiffany Green. That's me. All right, so we have a fantastic crew that will be on the call for the Cricket Celebration Bowl. And one of our team members, Quint Kesnick, caught up with South Carolina State head coach Buddy Pough about how special it is to be here.
What do you find yourself focusing on in an environment that's going to be off the charts? 50,000 fans, a sellout, this game's got all sorts of attention. How do you get your team to remain focused?
Business as usual. You try to tell them that it's the same place that they played in many times before. We played at Clemson. We played in Tampa Bay. You know, we played in all those kind of venues before. So it's no different that way. We just got to get started. And from the time that we get started, then it's just football.
And we know that we're getting ready for football game here, and Buddy Pough, he's seen everything there. But on the other side, Jackson State, Tiffany, you had an opportunity to catch up with Coach Prime.
Atlanta, the home that chose Coach Deion Sanders back in the day, prime time. Now you get a chance to lead your Jackson State team for a Black College National Championship. How special is it for you to be here?
Wow, it seems surreal. I mean, I'm just walking right here and sharing the moment with Kevin Mathis because he's coached youth all the way up with me through high school, and now we're here. It's an unbelievable feeling. I'm still in awe.
I'm just curious, does Drake's song started from the bottom?
Now we're here.
Whoop! Started from the bottom.
Now
the whole team here. Oh, yeah. All right. Back here at Black College Live. And you know what? We have to welcome in a third member of our team. He has been with us all season long, and he's had experience coaching in the MEAC and the SWAC. None other than our resident coach chef, Jay Martin. What's good?
Hey, guys. How y'all doing?
Coach chef, you normally bring me some food, but we'll give you a pass. We're indoor here doing a little bit different here. You've had a great year.
Yeah.
Great year. Your best year predicted. I want to say, what'd you come in at?
9-2.
Nine and two. Who's counting? 9-2. That's pretty good here.
Say you count, coach chef. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Say it with your chest.
9-2.
But before we do it, you know, obviously I've called the action there. Yeah. We've got that going on. So I'm going to give you a couple of my keys to the game and why I think this game can go a different way.
Okay.
If you're talking South Carolina State, most people know, how do they have a chance to win this football game? Right? Everybody wants to know. Jackson State rolling their hot.
Right.
Defense wins championships.
Yep.
And we talked about the long legacy of defense by South Carolina State, mm-hmm. particularly we talk about them representing the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference. Yep. It's not a normal Bulldog defense, right. but it's pretty good right there.
Yes.
Two is, I mentioned it earlier, the MEAC is 4-1 in this game. They've only lost one time, and their one loss in the Cricket Celebration Bowl was by 1 point, 10-9, against an explosive Grambling State team that can only come up with 10 points there. Right. So I think it's all out there. Bulldogs have had a little bit more time to rest, but Jackson State, Shedeur Sanders, I'm not going against Shedeur Sanders. I'm not saying it's a gimme. But I'm just saying I understand why everybody would be leaning that direction.
Wait a minute. I thought you, because you called a game, you don't chime in on who you think is going to win the game. That's Coach Chef's job.
I said everybody else is going there. I can understand why. Mm-hmm. I'm telling you, I can understand why. But it's not my job. I don't predict who's going to win. I just tell you about the matchup.
That's right. Hey, guys, Jackson State might be the hottest team, but my Rodale pick of the week, South Carolina State.
South Carolina State Bulldogs. You're calling the upset.
Yes.
Why are you calling the upset?
Because the coaching staff is seasoned. South Carolina State coaching staff, they've been around a long time. And they play really good defense. Really good defense.
What a fantastic season this has been.
Whoa.
The band's still getting revved up. For Jay Martin and Jay Walker, I'm Tiffany Greene. Thanks so much for being with us on Black College Live. We out.
Yeah. You're watching Gimme 5.
Black College Live.
Black College Live.
Yeah. This is a Gimme 5 show with Jay Walker and Tiffany. Yeah. You gon' have to give me 5 fingers on it. Right now,
I'm all excited. You see that?
Wait until they see the strength and hear the win. It's Black College Live. I'ma need 5 on it.
This is what it's all about.
Overtime on it. Lights out.
I'ma put him in the front runner seat to be the Black College Player of the Year.
This ain't for fun. I've been going done. They be still trying to clone it. From fam, you to Grambling, I'm on it. Stand on it. Marching 100, how you want it?
We always like to highlight the fraternities and sororities.
119.